All praise be to Allah and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was sitting with his friends. May Allah be pleased with them. Then the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, a man from amongst the inhabitants of paradise will appear to you. Then a man arrived and his beard was dripping with water from wudu. The next day, the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, an inhabitant of paradise will appear to you. And then the same man appeared. On the third day, the Prophet, peace be upon him, said the same. And the exact same man appeared. Therefore, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, radiallahu anhu, wanted to know why Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said such a thing about that guy. So he followed that man and said that he had a dispute with his father and needed to stay with the man for 3 days. The man welcomed him. Here is the surprising part. Abdullah radiallahu anhu stayed with him for 3 days, but he didn't see him doing anything unusual. He didn't see him praying at night. The only thing he noticed was that whenever the man moved in his sleep, he would remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say Allahu Akbar. Also, Abdullah radiallahu anhu didn't notice him saying anything except good. Then Abdullah radiallahu anhu said, after 3 nights, I began to underestimate his deeds. Therefore, Abdullah radiallahu anhu said to the man, O servant of Allah, I have never had any arguments with my father, but I hear the Prophet, peace be upon him, say 3 times that you are among the inhabitants of paradise. And I wanted to know what led you to reach this position, because I didn't observe you doing extra good deeds. How did you reach that level? And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said so about you. The man replied, I do what you have seen, yet I never achieve nor envy someone of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to them. Thus, Abdullah radiallahu anhu said, that is the reason you have reached this level, and it is a challenge for us. Because of his pure heart, he was an inhabitant of paradise. There were no bad words, grudges, disputes, hatred, envy, jealousy, cheating, or betrayal in his heart towards anyone. With a pure and calm mind and a peaceful heart, he sleeps every night. I remember once someone insulted my neighbor and told him bad words. He had a heart attack, so they took him to the hospital for urgent surgery. It's all because someone said bad words to him. We are human. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored us and gave us dignity. And of course, we should get angry and sad if someone insults us. However, Islam teaches us to control our anger and forgive others, because forgiveness benefits us. Just as bravery and courage come at times when we fear something, so too does forgiveness and mercy arise when we're angry. What about assumptions and thinking poorly of others? You know, nothing makes one happier and relieves one's heart more than thinking well of others. It protects one from the harm of worrisome thoughts that disturb his peace of mind and exhaust the body. The practice of thinking well of people increases heart health, strengthens the bonds of love and friendship among individuals, and frees the heart from hate and jealousy. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, beware of assumptions. for assumptions is the falsest of speech. And don't be inquisitive. And don't spy upon one another. And don't vie with one another. And don't envy one another. And don't hate one another. And don't shun one another. Be fellow brothers and slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, if the Muslim community adhered to such sublime behavior, their enemies would never dare to attack them. And their famous policy, divide and rule, would never succeed, since the hearts would be united and the souls pure. Masha Allah, I want to live this peaceful and happy state, and I want to go to Jannah. Would you be able to suggest ways for me to think well of others? Sure, there are certainly many ways that Muslims can think well of others, and I will tell you about them next time, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. And there is a precious dua which Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, taught his companions to say after التشهد in the prayer, Allahumma alif bayna qulubina wa aslih dhata baynina wahdina subul as-salam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our hearts from grudge, hatred and jealousy and grant us paradise. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.